If you're a diabetic, you know that high blood sugar is bad news. You also know that the best way to reduce your sugar levels is to watch what you eat, to keep the sugars and simple carbs to a minimum, to swap that ice cream for Greek yogurt. But what you may not know is that there are other things that you may be doing that contribute to high blood sugar. There are a number of simple lifestyle changes that can stabilize blood sugar levels in as little as a week. And that can make a big improvement in preventing and reversing diabetes. So in this video, we'll explore 10 ways to reduce your blood sugar in 1 week, naturally. But first, take a moment to like this video and subscribe to our channel and ring that bell for notifications so you can get even more diabetes-specific tips to live a healthy and full life. Finally, stay tuned until the end to get 2 free gifts from us. You probably already understand that you need to manage your blood sugar. However, you may not realize just how high the stakes are. Blood sugar that's too high can have both short and long-term effects. If left unmanaged for too long, high blood sugar can lead to heart attack or stroke, sometimes fatal. In 2012, an estimated 2.2 million deaths resulted from high blood sugar, a trend that's accelerating with the modern lifestyle. For other people, it's not fatal, but it turns life upside down, causing blindness, amputations, and nervous system damage. That's scary, but there's good news. By making a few healthy adjustments, the future can be much brighter. So we've compiled 10 of the best ways to reduce blood sugar naturally. Let's jump into it. Number 10, stay hydrated. Water is the healthiest beverage, whether you're diabetic or not. No calories, no carbs, and vital to keeping our bodies functioning. Water helps to flush out excess glucose, and it can reduce someone's risk of diabetes if they are prone to it. The amount of water you need can depend on many different factors, but most people need at least 2 liters a day. Go for pure water, as anything with added sugar will counteract its effects. Or add some fresh lemon or mint for a diabetes-friendly boost of antioxidants and beneficial phenolic compounds. So if you're not getting enough water, this is a simple adjustment that can make a huge difference. Try it for a week and see how you feel. Number 9, get quality sleep. Haven't been sleeping the best? It may affect your blood sugar. That's right, sleep is essential, but many people are not getting enough. Not sleeping enough can really do a number on your body. It reduces your focus, makes you physically fatigued, and can impact your diabetes. In fact, a lack of sleep is associated with an increased risk of developing diabetes to begin with. One reason is that hunger increases when you're sleep deprived. Also, it can lower the release of growth hormones and increase cortisol levels, messing with insulin sensitivity and making it even harder to control your sugar levels. In no time, this can become a difficult cycle to escape. So, how much sleep do you need? It changes from person to person, but 7 to 9 hours is a good ballpark. If you're having trouble sleeping, it's important to practice sleep hygiene. These are the rituals or routines that you do before bed that can hurt or help your sleep. For example, a relaxing bath 90 minutes before bed has been shown to improve sleep quality. Blocking out sound and light is also beneficial. And as for mobile phones, the blue light emitted by phones is believed to reduce melatonin production, an important chemical for sleep. Not to mention the thought trains that get triggered by late-night news or social check-ins. So make your bedroom a sanctuary for sleep and create a nighttime wind-down routine that works best for you. And on a similar note, number 8, relax. Another reason why your blood sugar levels may be high, you're stressed. When you're stressed, your body releases hormones. These hormones, mainly cortisol and glucagon, can raise blood sugar. While stress is a natural part of life, if you're feeling stressed all the time, it's important to change that. Addressing the stress that you can control is a good place to start. However, you may be stressed about things outside of your control, like the pandemic or behavior of other people. The main way you can reduce stress is to do something relaxing. Meditate, try yoga, or dedicate time to doing something that you love. A 2017 study found that just 8 sessions of mindfulness-based stress reduction significantly improved glycemic control, plus improved broader emotional well-being. Give yourself time to let go. It might just be the best investment you ever make. Next, we'll discuss one of the most potent things you can do to relieve stress and reduce diabetes. But first, let's discuss one more stress reduction option: asking for help. Don't be afraid to ask for help. If your friends and family can help you, ask. And if you are able to seek a therapist, it can be transformative. Otherwise, positive distractions can be useful. Unwind with a good show or book. Train your mind to focus on the present moment and nothing else. To summarize, reducing stress has an enormous impact on the body, including glucose moderation and diabetes. Number 7, exercise. Exercise plays a big role in diabetes management. For one thing, it helps you to manage your weight along with proper diet. For another, it reduces stress and helps you sleep better at night. The other major reason why exercise is so important? Your body uses blood glucose when you work out. When you lift weights or do a cardio workout, your muscles burn that blood glucose. By exercising an hour or so a day, you'll soon see a difference. And it doesn't need to be intense. A brisk walk in the park or an hour of dancing can have a big impact. Next, we'll jump into some important minerals that you may not have been told about. But first, it's time to reveal your 2 free gifts. Get an in-depth look at the foods which can help you fight diabetes. Download our free book, The 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar, and learn what's really happening inside your body. Plus, watch our free 1-hour documentary, The Scary Truth About Sugar. Simply click on the link in the description below to gain full access to both gifts. All right, let's jump into number 6. Number 6, eat more magnesium and chromium. There are minerals that are vital to keep everything balanced, and the deficiency in magnesium can increase your chances of developing diabetes. So making sure you get enough can improve blood sugar control. You can find magnesium in whole grains, bananas, beans, leafy greens, tuna, and through supplements. Chromium helps to regulate blood sugar too. You can find chromium in most natural foods like fruits, nuts, veggies, whole grains, and some meats. Number 5, a dash of apple cider vinegar. Apple cider vinegar seems to help everything function better, including blood glucose. Research published in the International Journal of Diabetes found that the chlorogenic acid in apple cider vinegar may help to control cholesterol, balancing blood glucose, as well as supporting weight loss and reducing hypertension. So, how do you take your apple cider vinegar? Try mixing a teaspoon with lemon water as your first drink of the day. Apple cider vinegar can also be a delicious addition to a diabetic-friendly salad dressing, or you can take it as a supplement capsule for a consistent dosage. However, too much apple cider vinegar can interact with some diabetes medications, so if you have concerns, talk to your doctor, and limit your consumption to no more than 2 tablespoons per day. Number 4. Add some fenugreek seeds. Fenugreek seeds have been used as herbal medicine throughout history, dating back to 1500 BC in Egypt. One reason is that they contain soluble fiber. Furthermore, studies found that the compounds of fenugreek seeds significantly reduced HbA1c levels and improved glucose metabolism. So, how do you eat fenugreek? You can add them to salads or baked goods. And another study found that drinking fenugreek seeds soaked in hot water is beneficial for diabetics. Anyone up for a cup of fenugreek tea? Number 3. You may need more fiber. One of the best pieces of advice for a diabetic is eat more fiber. Fiber helps with digestion and is vital to keeping the body functioning properly. There are two main types, soluble and insoluble. What's the difference? Soluble fiber can be dissolved in water. The water turns it into a gel, which helps slow digestion. Foods with soluble fiber can keep you full longer and are what you need for blood sugar control. So what about insoluble fiber? Insoluble fiber helps to promote regularity. In other words, if you're having trouble in the bathroom, insoluble fiber can help. Insoluble fiber helps to clear out the digestive system, as well as maintaining beneficial gut bacteria, all of which improves your body's glucose response. Good sources of soluble fiber include vegetables, fruit, beans, oats, nuts, and seeds. Number 2. Limit your carbs. If you're a diabetic, one rule you may hear a lot is that you should avoid simple carbs. These are typically found in refined grains, candy, and other foods that have little nutrition. Whole grains can be a good way to get complex carbs. With that said, you may consider lowering the amount of carbs you consume in general. You may choose to consider a keto diet. In a keto diet, you eat around 20 to 50 net carbs a day, depending on your needs. What are net carbs? They are the total carbohydrate minus fiber. If something has 15 total carbs and 5 grams of fiber, it has 10 net carbs. Lowering your carbs can help to improve your blood sugar levels, but it doesn't even have to be a full-on keto diet. Just cutting the amount of carbs that you have can help. Number 1. Lose some weight. Excess weight is the number one predictor of diabetes. In fact, a 2006 study found that participants reduced their diabetes risk by a whopping 16% for every kilogram of weight they lost. Now, we're not talking about diet pills or liposuction here. It's all about lifestyle changes that help the body to function optimally. Specifically, food choices, portion control, and exercise. And the good news, it doesn't have to be extreme, and you don't have to miss out on delicious foods. Quite the opposite. We're here to show you how to make it easier, to teach you restaurant quality recipes and cooking techniques that not only taste delicious, but also give you greater energy and mental clarity, all while helping your body to prevent or reduce diabetes risk. As well as advice about introducing diabetes-friendly habits in ways that are effective and sustainable for the long term. So start where you are today and get action happening. Even a 10% improvement can quickly add up. Finally, with any lifestyle change, it's always good to run it by your doctor, especially if you have diabetes complications. For example, in some cases, improving glucose control can require reduction in medication. A fantastic step, but one that requires input from a doctor. And there you have it. Now you have some clear steps to lower your blood sugar in a week. Naturally lowering your blood sugar is possible, and it can be hugely empowering. It's all about adjusting habits, and while it can take a while to change habits, it's important to keep trying. Be patient with yourself and always be willing to try again. Eventually, you will be able to see results. We believe in you, and we are here to support you. Perhaps there's something that works really well for you? Share your favorite tips and routines with the Diabetics Talk community in the comments below. And before you leave, make sure to claim your free gift by clicking the link in the description below. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell button for more Diabetes Talk. Thanks for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.